back to Crafty Little Things. I'm Andrea and I'm going to be making this magic bubbles hexagon, which is from book 46 of Big and Little Crochet. If you're not sure what it is, do check my Big and Little Crochet playlist. There's all sorts of videos on there showing the books, the patterns, talking about what Big and Little's all about. But I will put a link below to the site as well. So for this one I need these four colours: white, slate, teal and river. And the yarns do come with the books. You get fresh yarns, but these are ones I've already had, so I'm using up leftovers. Sorry about that noise in the background. That was people walking out, going outside. Right, so we're going to start off using the teal yarn and we're going to make a foundation ring using a 4mm hook. This is my own 4mm hook, but you do get one with the kit right at the beginning as well. And I'm going to be crocheting in UK terms, but I will give the US terms as well. So we start off with a slip knot. Oh no, we don't. We usually start off with a slip knot, but we're starting off with a magic ring this time. I'm going to just move the book out of shot, just so that you can see better what I'm doing. And I'll zoom in a little bit so that you can better see what I'm doing. Now, to make a magic ring, how I do it, you can do it however you like. I do have an absolute beginner's playlist and there is a really slow, detailed tutorial on how to make a magic ring using a big hook and a big yarn, so it's really clear to see. But what I do is I lay the yarn over my fingers like that. I fold it over and catch it just like I would for a slip knot. And then I put my hook underneath the first strand, pull through the second strand, give it a bit of a twist so it doesn't come off, and then go back for some more of that second strand and pull it through the loop on my hook. And then I can take my fingers out and I have my magic ring. This is my straggler, this is my ring, and this is my working yarn. So that's the bit I need to pick up. Now, if I want to make the ring smaller, I can just pull on the straggler there. Okay, so now I'm ready to start. So I make the magic ring and then the pattern tells me to chain three. One, two, three. And I just want to say, if you've not been here before, I do work the pattern for the first time on this video. I don't practice it before, I don't even look at it before, to be honest. So it is a crochet along style. Then we want to put 11 trebles into the ring. So this first chain three is our standing chain. It's just got to the height of a treble. In the US, this is a double. So yarn over, put your hook into the ring, pull through a loop of yarn. You've got three loops now on your hook. Yarn over and pull through two of those loops. Yarn over and pull through the remaining two. And that's your treble or a double in the US. Now I will do that just really slowly. I'll just zoom right in and I'll do it really slowly just for anybody who wants to make this but really is a beginner. So you yarn over and then you pop your hook into the ring, grab your yarn, pull it through to the front of the ring so you've got three loops on your hook. Then you yarn over again and you pull through those two loops on your hook. And that leaves you with two loops. And then you yarn over and you pull through those two loops and that leaves you with one loop and that's your stitch there. So we're going to do that 11 times so that we've got 11 treble crochets or double crochets in the US and this standing chain of three, which counts as a treble crochet. So effectively we've got 12. Okay, so that's three, this is four. Chain there. So yes, I've done mine. So I'm going to join with a slip stitch to the top of the chain three. So I'm going to pull my straggler in nice and tight, take my hook, go back to this starting chain of three, one, two, three, pop my hook in, pull through some yarn and then pull it through the loop on my hook, and that gives us a little circle to start off with. And then we're going to fasten that yarn off. We'll need it again later, but we're done with it for now. And I'm going to be really bad and use paper scissors instead of embroidery scissors because I forgot to get some out. So there we go, we just pull the yarn through and snip it off. So now we're going to join white to any stitch. So we take our white, unravel some yarn. It's easier if you have some yarn unraveled, or if you use a yarn bowl or a yarn holder or something. So I'm going to, I've said that, now I've lost the end. So now what I'm going to do is join the white to any chain three, to any stitch, sorry. So what you want to do, if you're joining to a stitch, you want to put your hook underneath the two pieces of the stitch. You see that? Under the two pieces, rather than between the posts. And then I just wrap my yarn, lay my yarn over my hook, pull it through, and then using the straggler and the working yarn, I yarn over and pull those through, and that just gives me a nice tight join. So then with chain three, well, I'm going to count my join as chain one. So then that's chain two and chain three. Okay. I'm going to try and sew this white one in as I go along. So then I want to do a treble in the same stitch. So yarn over and put your hook into that same stitch. Grab some yarn, pull it through. Yarn over, pull through two. Yarn over, pull through two. And then we want to do two trebles in every stitch around. Sorry, we've got a bit blurred there. So yarn over, go into the next stitch. I'm holding this straggler behind the work so I can crochet it in. Into the next stitch and do a treble crochet or a double crochet in the US. And then in the same stitch, do another one. Okay. And that's what I'm going to do all the way around. Holding my straggler, going to the next stitch. I'm familiar with some of the techniques and the terminology, and they could probably work a bit faster and they just want to crochet along. Others might just want this particular hexagon and it might be their first attempt. So you try to sort of cater for everybody. So I'll do my last two in this stitch, and then I'm just going to go back and count just to make sure that I have 24, including that chain three. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, I do. So now I'm going to put my hook into the top of that chain three. Pull through some yarn. And pull it through the loop on my hook. And then pull through some more and fasten off. So now we're going to join them with yarn to any stitch. So again, we'll do exactly the same thing. I'm going to go in underneath the two little strands there, and I'll show you a different way this time. You pull your yarn through and just tie it on. Tie it on with two knots, and then what I do is I put my hook in, grab the yarn, and just do a chain just to secure it. Then I'm going to work that in. So we're going to chain three. So that first chain to secure it is one, then two, and three, and then we're going to do two trebles in the same stitch. So yarn over into the same stitch that we added it to, and do a treble and then another treble in the same stitch. So that's quite, oops, that's quite packed in there. So yarn over into that stitch, pull through a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Then one treble in the next stitch. So yarn over, I'm going to get this straggler, one treble into the next stitch. And then we're going to yarn over and we're going to put two trebles in the next stitch. And another one into the same stitch. Then we're going to yarn over and put one treble into the next. And then we're going to yarn over and put two trebles into the next. All the time I'm working that straggler in. Then yarn over, one treble into the next. Yarn over and two trebles, or doubles in the US, into the next. Yarn over one. Yarn over two. One yarn over two. Now the next step is to rejoin the slate. So if we look in our little glossary, MB is to make a bobble. So what we do is we work three double trebles into the stitch. So I'm going to chain one, two, three. And then I'm going to yarn over, yarn over. And then I'm going to put my yarn in, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, and stop. Then I'm going to yarn over twice, go into the same stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, and stop. So now I've essentially got three double trebles. I'm going to yarn over, pull through all three, and then do a chain to secure and push the bobble through. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do double crochet in the next stitch. So a double crochet is a single in the US. So I'm going to put my yarn, my hook into my stitch, grab a loop, pull it through, yarn over and pull through the two on my hook. And then I'm going to do a bobble in the next stitch. And I'm going to carry on like that, a double crochet in the next, a bobble in the next, a double crochet in the next. So I'm going to yarn over twice, put my hook into my stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over twice, into the same stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over twice, into the same stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through all three, one chain, and then a double crochet in the next stitch. Okay, yarn over twice, into the next stitch, and we're going to do that same thing again. Three unfinished double trebles in the US, and then join them all together at the end and add a little securing chain, and then drop down and just pop a double crochet in the next stitch. Okay, so I've finished that and I'm here at the end now. So I'm going to slip stitch into the top of this first bobble stitch here and finish off. We don't need that slate yarn anymore now, that's done. So now we need to rejoin the teal yarn, and we're going to rejoin it to the back of any bobble. What you might want to do is just push your bobble stitches forward, because they do tend to stick sort of protrude out the back of your work. So if you push them. So now what you want to do is fasten your teal to the back of a bobble stitch. So if you notice on your bobble stitches, you have this loop sort of at the back. Go into that and join your teal yarn as we've joined it before. This is our double crochet there in between the bobble stitches. So we yarn over, go into that double crochet, yarn over twice, go into that double crochet, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two and stop, yarn over twice, go back into there, repeat that, yarn over twice, go back into there, repeat that again, and then this time yarn over and pull through all of the stitches on the hook. Do a chain one to secure and then do a double crochet into the top of the bobble stitch itself. So go into the top of there where you pulled it all through together, pull through a loop, yarn over, pull through two and secure. Then go into the next bobble stitch, yarn over twice, go into the top of the double crochet, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over twice, into that same stitch, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over twice, into that same stitch, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through all the loops on your hook, chain one, and then do a double crochet, a single in the US, into the top of the next bobble. And that's how we're working along. So we get these bobble stitches intermittent with these the bobble stitches from the previous round. So we've just finished that last bobble stitch. So I'm just going to slip stitch now to the first bobble stitch. No, I'm going to go into the top of this bobble stitch and do my double crochet and then slip stitch into the top of the first bobble stitch and then fasten off. So that's that one done. This is a very, it's probably one of the ones that's taken the longest to do. Just push all those bobbles through. And to be quite honest, I don't like all this bobble stitching. It looks lovely, but it's just boring doing it for me. But it does look beautiful and it's going to make a really tactile hexagon. So we go on to white now. And we're going to join the white to any one double crochet, treble, two chains and two trebles in the same stitch. So yarn over into the same stitch, work a treble crochet, which is a double in the US, chain two, and then do, yarn over once, I've got that used to yarning over twice, and do two more trebles in the same stitch. And this will probably be our first corner. And then we go to the next double crochet and we do three trebles into that. So one, yarn over into the same stitch, two, three into that. Then we go to our next double crochet, which is after this bobble stitch here. And we put three treble crochets, doubles in the US, into that. One, two, 3, and that's working the side of our hexagon. So this is going to be a corner, this is the side, and then into the next one we're going to work another corner. So we're going to put two trebles, two chains, and two trebles all into the same, which is a corner. And then we're just going to repeat that. So we're going to work a corner, which is two trebles, two chains, two trebles. Then in the next double crochet, we're going to put three doubles. In the next one, we're going to put three doubles, and then we're going to work another corner. So that's how it's going to work. So let's just do another one together. So I'm going to put three into this double crochet, and then I'm going to put three into the next double crochet. One, two, three, and then I'm going to work another corner. And then with the last piece, we just go into the top of that chain three and pull through and finish off. And there we have it. And so there we have it, that lovely hexagon, which took a while but was worth it, and it's going to look lovely in the blanket. Okay, so join me next time for the hexagon from book 47, and any questions, just drop them below. Thank you. See you soon. Bye-bye.